You're listening to the audio production of For These Tough Times, Reaching Toward Heaven for Hope and Healing by Max Lucado, published by Thomas Nelson and read by Ben Holland.
Introduction. When all that is good falls apart. When all that is good falls apart, what can good people do? The Lord is in His holy temple. The Lord sits on His throne in heaven. Psalm 11:3 and 4. Isn't David's question ours? When all that is good falls apart, what can good people do? When illness invades, marriages fail, children suffer, and death strikes, what are we to do? Curiously, David doesn't answer his question with an answer. He answers it with a declaration. The Lord is in His holy temple. The Lord sits on His throne in heaven. His point is unmistakable. God is unaltered by our storms. He is undeterred by our problems. He is unfrightened by these problems. He is in His holy temple. He is on His throne in heaven. Buildings may fall, careers may crumble, but God does not. Wreckage and rubble have never discouraged Him. God has always turned tragedy into triumph. Did He not do so with Joseph? Look at Joseph in the Egyptian prison. His brothers have sold him out. Potiphar's wife has turned him in. If ever a world has caved in, Joseph's has. Or consider Moses, watching flocks in the wilderness. Is this what he intended to do with his life? Hardly. His heart beats with Jewish blood. His passion is to lead the slaves. So why does God have him leading sheep? And Daniel? What about Daniel? He was among the brightest and best young men of Israel, the equivalent of a West Point cadet or an Ivy Leaguer. But he and his entire generation are being marched out of Jerusalem. The city is destroyed. The temple is in ruins. Joseph in prison, Moses in the desert, Daniel in chains. These were dark moments. Who could have seen any good in them? Who could have known that Joseph the prisoner was just one promotion from becoming Joseph the prime minister? Who would have thought that God was giving Moses 40 years of wilderness training in the very desert through which he would lead the people? And who could have imagined that Daniel the captive would soon be Daniel the king's counselor? God does things like that. He did with Joseph, with Moses, with Daniel, and most of all, He did with Jesus. In our toughest times, we may see what the followers of Christ saw on the cross: innocent slaughtered, goodness murdered, heaven's tower of strength pierced. Mothers wept, evil danced, and the apostles had to wonder, when all that is good falls apart, what can good people do? God answered their question with a declaration. With the rumble of the earth and the rolling of the rock, He reminded them, "The Lord is in His holy temple. The Lord sits on His throne in heaven." And today, we must remember, He still is. He is still in His temple, still on His throne, still in control. And He still makes princes out of prisoners, counselors out of captives, and Sundays out of Fridays. What He did then, He will do still. It falls to us to ask Him to do so. In this book, we'll ask the questions that trouble us all during difficult times. Who is our God? Where is God in all of this? Can good come from evil? And prayer. Is God really listening? As we ponder these questions together, I pray that God's peace and understanding will touch your heart and bring healing to your spirit. Max Lucado. 1. Where is God? When tragedy strikes, whether personal, national, or global, people wonder how God could allow such things to happen. What can He be thinking? Is God really in control? Can we trust Him to run the universe if He would allow this? it is important to recognize that God dwells in a different realm. He occupies another dimension. My thoughts are not like your thoughts. Your ways are not like my ways. Just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. Isaiah 55:8-9. Make special note of the word like. God's thoughts are not our thoughts, nor are they even like ours. We aren't even in the same neighborhood. We're thinking, preserve the body. He's thinking, save the soul. We dream of a pay raise. He dreams of raising the dead. We avoid pain and seek peace. God uses pain to bring peace. I'm going to live before I die, we resolve. Die so you can live, he instructs. We love what rusts. He loves what endures. We rejoice at our successes. He rejoices at our confessions. We show our children the Nike star with the million-dollar smile and say, be like Mike. God points to the crucified carpenter with bloody lips and a torn side and says, be like Christ. Our thoughts are not like God's thoughts. Our ways are not like His ways. He has a different agenda. He dwells in a different dimension. He lives on another plane. The heavens tell the glory of God, and the skies announce what His hands have made. Day after day, they tell the story. Night after night, they tell it again. They have no speech or words. They have no voice to be heard. But their message goes out through all the world. Their words go everywhere on earth. Psalm 19:1-4. Nature is God's workshop. The sky is His resume. The universe is His calling card. You want to know who God is? See what He has done. You want to know His power? Take a look at His creation. Curious about His strength? Pay a visit to His home address, 1 billion Starry Sky Avenue. Want to know His size? Step out into the night and stare at starlight emitted 1 million years ago. And then listen to 2 Chronicles 2:6. No one can really build a house for our God. Not even the highest of heavens can hold Him. He is untainted by the atmosphere of sin, unbridled by the timeline of history, unhindered by the weariness of the body. What controls you doesn't control Him. What troubles you doesn't trouble Him. What fatigues you doesn't fatigue Him. Is an eagle disturbed by traffic? No, he rises above it. Is the whale perturbed by a hurricane? Of course not. He plunges beneath it. Is the lion flustered by the mouse standing directly in his way? No, he steps over it. How much more is God able to soar above, plunge beneath, and step over the troubles of the earth? What is impossible with man is possible with God.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.